Let's get answers to calculate the reaction forces as part of post-processing. One thing to keep in mind is that the way FEA codes calculate the reactions at the displays at the locations that you've constrained the structure is different from how you do it from hand calculations usually, and definitely in this case. In the hand calculations, you know, this is a statically determined truss, so we can calculate the reactions just by doing force balance in X, Y, and also the moment balance about the Z axis. In contrast, in FEA, the reactions come from the nodal displacements, in this case, the pin displacements. Remember, everything comes from those nodal displacements once they have been determined. So let's take a look at how ANSYS calculates the reactions from the pin displacements, or the nodal displacements equivalently in this case. Earlier, I had written an expression for the potential energy. So you add the potential energy of the three bars, and then you subtract out the external force. Now, this is not the whole story, because there's also, you know, the reactions can be considered external forces. Let me annotate that. So at pin A, you really have an external force. I'll call that RAY, reaction at A in the Y direction. And there is RAX, reaction at A in the X direction. And similarly here, you have a reaction at B in the Y direction. These are external forces acting on the pins, so you need to augment the potential energy expression with the contributions from those. So this one will give me minus RAX and the displacement there, UAX minus RAY, UAY minus RBY, UBY. I know what you're thinking. You probably are thinking that, you know, these are zero from the constraints, and so the contribution to the potential energy is zero. That's true. But the key thing is, you know, what's a contribution to the potential energy if you slightly perturb, let's say, UAX? If you slightly perturb UAX at equilibrium, since you are at the minimum potential energy point, the potential energy has to increase. So if I make UAX slightly positive, then the potential energy would increase from the equilibrium value. If you make UAX slightly negative, again, that would be the case. And you can see that, you know, if you plot the potential energy versus UAX, okay, it's going to vary like this, and that's equilibrium, and of course it's the value is zero over there. But this also means that the derivative of the potential energy with respect to UAX has to be zero, and that'll give me, you know, this, if you look at, first let's take a look at the at these terms, the external force terms, the only one that would contribute is this one. So I would get minus RAX, just that term, because I take the derivative of that. This is from differentiating the potential energy. And then pi BAB is going to have a contribution. It's going to look something like KAB U BX minus UAX. You can think of this as with analogy to the spring, right? K times the extension in the spring. And I talked about this in the pre-analysis also, how the algebraic equations are related. And then I'm also going to get a contribution from KAC, and it's going to be more complicated because it's inclined to the coordinate axis, is equal to zero. Now that is that's an algebraic equation connecting, you know, relating the reaction AX to the displacements, which are all known at this point. And so one can calculate the reaction similarly for the other two reactions. Let's get answers to, you know, generate this equation and calculate RAX. So go to answers, and I'll highlight solution in the tree, and I'll say probe force reaction. And I will, so, you know, I can ignore weak springs, displacement and displacement 2. So I can calculate the reactions corresponding to these two specified displacements or this displacement. Let me do that with respect to displacement, and then I'll say evaluate all results. And you can see that, you know, that's RAX. So that's RAX, and it's generated from writing d pi d uax is equal to 0. And that balances the external force, okay, and that's in, because it's negative. So that's a check that that value is, makes sense. And similarly, you know, you can get the other reactions and so on. If you understand how the reactions get calculated from the displacement in FEA code, it puts you ahead of maybe, you know, 90% of students who usually think reactions come from some kind of FEA magic. So doing it in ANSYS is easy. Understanding what's under the hood takes a little bit more thought.